From Nashville's WSM Radio, the original home of the Grand Ole Opry, this is a Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast.
Hey, it's Charlie Matos, and welcome to our Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast. In this episode, we sit down with one of the true icons of daytime television in the United States, Susan Lucci. What a career. And in more recent years, a great spokesperson for the American Heart Association. It's a fascinating story. I hope you enjoy our Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast with Susan Lucci. Well, we here at WSM Radio and Circle Television are just thrilled to partner with our friends at the American Heart Association. I'm Charlie Matos. That's Jennifer Vickery-Smith, Eric Markham. And talk about thrilled. We are so excited for our guest this morning. TV Guide simply called her one of the 50 greatest TV stars of all time.
All time.
Susan Lucci, welcome to WSM Radio and Circle Television.
Thank you so much. I'm so happy to be here. What a nice introduction.
Well, TV Guide made it easy for me, and a career made it easy for me as well.
So,
and we will certainly get to all my children. That's a no-brainer. I promise you that. But you've got so many exciting things happening here in Nashville. It's a 15th anniversary celebration for Carrie Underwood, and you're going to be on the Opry. But I understand this is not your first time at the Grand Ole Opry.
Oh, you've done your homework. Actually, I've been dying to come back. I'm so happy to be in Nashville and at the Grand Ole Opry in particular, because I have never been in the new one. Mm-hmm. And I mean, maybe it's not even that new anymore, but I was originally at the original.
The Mother Church, the Ryman
Mother
Auditorium.
Church. Yes.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Yeah.
I was thrilled to be invited. And they asked me to sing. And at the time, I had never sung professionally at all. And I said I would, but I really thought that part might go away. I thought, well, I'll just go and we'll figure it out. But in fact, the producer at the time called me at home and asked me for the key I sang it in. I said, I never did it professionally, so I had no idea what key. But anyway, I came, I sang, I got here. It was so much fun.
Yeah, there's something magical about the Grand Ole Opry.
Magical.
Yeah.
And you feel it the minute, I felt it the minute I walked into the Grand Ole Opry, and I'm sure I'm going to feel it again tonight.
Yeah.
There's so much history and new history and ongoing history.
Right.
Amazing performances. I'm thrilled to be here.
Yeah. Well, I mentioned our partnership with the American Heart Association.
Yes.
There have been so many monumental moments in your professional career, but boy, the fall of 2018 was a monumental moment in your personal and health, huh?
It was, and it came as such a shock to not only to me, but to our whole family, and even the cardiologist, who was not my cardiologist. I didn't need one until then.
You didn't even have one. One, right?
I didn't have one, but my husband did. I had been feeling at the beginning of October, then in 2018, a very just a light pressure on my chest. My husband and I were in a restaurant waiting to be seated, and as most women, I thought, oh, it's nothing. Oh, it'll go away. Mm-hmm. By the time we were seated, it did go away. The second time it happened a couple weeks later, only this time I had this also radiating pressure around my rib cage to my back. Mm-hmm. And I still thought, no, it can't be anything, because that's what we do.
Especially as women, we just don't automatically think that's what we're dealing with.
Exactly,
right?
And we'll wait and see.
Yeah, you know, exactly.
It'll be better. Mm-hmm. But 3 weeks later, I could not ignore it. I was shopping in a boutique for a girlfriend's birthday present, and the saleswoman stepped aside to wrap the gift, and I felt what I had heard a woman say in an interview many years ago on TV. She was not a celebrity. She was a woman talking about how symptoms for a woman can be very different than a man in a heart attack. Mm-hmm. And what she said she felt and what I was feeling was the feeling of an elephant pressing on my chest. So I couldn't imagine it. I had no health issues. My mother at the time was 100 years old. Mm-hmm. We all thought I had my mother's genes. Oh, yeah. I hope I have the rest of them now.
And you certainly do not look like someone who I would think would have heart issues. I mean,
Thank you. That's what my cardiologist said.
I mean, seriously. Yeah.
I wouldn't look at you and think that. But fortunately, so I sat down on a bench. The manager came over to me of the boutique and asked me if I was okay. I told her what was going on. Mm-hmm. And very calmly, she said, my car's outside, Susan. I can get you to St. Francis Hospital, which is the heart hospital in New York. It was a mile down the road. Mm-hmm. And she said, I'll get you there faster than an ambulance. And so I went in the car with her. And while I was going, I was thinking, this is my day off. I have too much to do.
You don't have time to
go to the hospital. And I, you know, as women, we have a to-do list, but we are not on it.
Right.
That's
so true. We take our children to the pediatrician. We're the advocates for the people we love. And we got stuff to do. And And I called my husband's cardiologist. I didn't know who else to call. And he was, everything his reputation is, he really picked up his phone. He told me to come on in. And he thought that my symptoms were substantial. And he called for a cardiac CAT scan. And he said, I can fix that. And I'll take you up to the OR either tonight. It was getting kind of late, like 9, 10 o'clock at night. Whoa. I'll take you up to the OR now, or I can do it first thing in the morning, 6:30 in the morning. You'll be first up. I said, well, wouldn't it be better to wait till 6:30 in the morning and all of your team will be in fresh and they'll be raring to go?
I like
and,
that. Right? Nobody's going to be tired at the end of the day.
No, bring your A-team in fresh in the morning. Yeah. He said, my A-team's on their way in. I said, well, shouldn't I go home and get a good night's sleep and come back at 6:30 in the morning? He said, I don't think you understand. Yeah, this, you could have a heart attack at any time. And it did not really dawn on me until he put two stents in. He had a heart surgeon standing by. They didn't find anything except, a 90% blockage in my main artery, wow. 75% in an adjacent. Mm-hmm. And he fixed it. I was released the next day by noon.
Wow.
Oh, my goodness.
But as I was leaving, the nurses said to me, it's a good thing you came in, because otherwise you would have had the widowmaker. 99% sure you would have had the widowmaker.
Wow. Mm.
And then it dawned on me what that was.
Yeah.
And the truth is, had I not been in that boutique and had my guardian angel on both my shoulders to be a mile away from that hospital, and the manager of the boutique also had a degree in nursing.
Hmm. Oh, wow.
Are you kidding?
Yeah.
So
what a 24 hours.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And now for you to be able to be someone in the spotlight that can share your story and just bring awareness. Mm-hmm. And particularly, I feel like as women, we don't put ourselves on the to-do list. I loved how you worded that. And then even then, when they're telling you, no, you really need to do this, you're thinking of that to-do list.
Right? Yeah. Wouldn't it be better if I go away for a while and come back?
What's the one piece of advice you would give to people listening and watching this morning?
It's kind of two-part. Okay. I would say listen to your body. Mm-hmm. And if your body's not behaving in a normal way for you, take action. Call the doctor. The other thing with women is we're afraid. I didn't want to disturb this wonderful cardiologist, take him away from the patients who really need him. This is another woman thing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But people in general, don't be afraid. Go take care of it. It's better to catch it early, whatever it's going to be.
Right.
Yeah. Take action. And very importantly, put yourself on your to-do list.
Mm-hmm. Make yourself a priority, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Give yourself permission as women. You're okay. Yeah. You can do that.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. Okay, let's talk about the fun stuff.
Yeah. Okay. So for 41 years, your to-do list was?
Yeah. Get to that studio on the west side of New York. Erica Kane.
Oh, the loyalty of you and that show and just the legendary status now of what we think of you from that show. What do you
Thank
miss
you.
The most about that daily routine?
Oh, well, a couple things. I miss playing the character because she was so much fun to play, even though it was a play a day. It was a lot of volume, but we all loved what we did, and I loved what I did. And the other thing is being part of that team.
Mm-hmm.
I miss that because that's a wonderful experience in
life.
It's
like a family, right?
It's like a family. You don't choose each other, but you spend 16 hours a day with each other in the trenches.
Mm-hmm.
And you have a lot of laughs. You're all on the same page with the same goal. And I was lucky to work with these amazing actors from mostly Broadway actors, some who had been in Hollywood, like Ruth Warwick, who was in Citizen Kane. I mean, so everyone was so accomplished, and there was such a trust. And from top to bottom, from producers to crew, we were a family.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So for a young college grad who grew up in Yonkers and Long Island, 41 years is not even on your radar. What do you think?
No.
I mean, it's an incredible break. It's a great role, but what do you think? In 2 or 3 years, then maybe I do some Broadway. I mean, you can't even imagine 4 decades, right?
No. I had to be convinced to even sign a contract because the contract was for 3 years, and the most I ever knew was a 4-year contract, so to speak, going to high school and college. So 3 years was enormous.
Mm-hmm.
And my agent said to me, don't worry, if you don't like it, we'll get you out of it. I mean, that's what he said. And we were on probation, those of us playing I was playing a 15-year-old Erica.
Mm-hmm.
And for those of us playing the high school kids, there were 4 of us, we were on probation for the first 5 shows. So you know, there was a lot of heavy breathing in my dressing room before I went out, you know, yeah. to do it because we were on probation. Right.
Does that mean you were still earning the role to stay
kind
on?
Kind of, okay. yes. Yeah. If they had the option mm-hmm. to change their mind
yeah.
after five episodes.
They wow. sure didn't change their mind, did they? After no. 41 years.
No. And how cool that it was shot in New York. So it's your hometown show.
Exactly. You know? And I could, we could raise our children actually in my hometown. Mm-hmm. And that was very sweet. I loved having that combination of things, my life in New York and then LA and everywhere, Atlanta, Nashville. Yeah. But to have a home base like that, mm-hmm. where I grew up, and it's that kind of town. It's multi-generational. People mm-hmm. move back. Mm-hmm. My parents were still there. Kids I went to high school were all back raising our families. Not everybody, but a mm-hmm. whole bunch. So when it came prom time or party time, mm-hmm. you could call each other and say, are the parents really going to be home? You know?
<Yeah. laughs> I made that phone call. I know what that one's like.
Right?
Oh, my. So, and about a decade ago, you wrote a wonderful autobiography.
Oh, thank you.
So for those who maybe want to learn more inside stuff, I would send them to All My Life.
Yes.
A memoir.
Memoir, yep.
But hopefully the Grand Ole Opry will be your home on Saturday night.
Oh, yes.
We'll have a lot of fun there with Carrie Underwood.
Absolutely. And I admire her so much. Mm-hmm. I was rooting for her when she was first beginning, yeah. and wow. She has never disappointed. Yeah. She's fantastic.
Yeah. And there's nothing like the energy of that live crowd.
Oh,
right?
Yeah. Absolutely. There's nothing like that. To be on stage with a live audience. Mm-hmm. And I mean, I'm getting chills thinking. Yeah. The Grand Ole Opry. That's fantastic.
Well, you look so beautiful. You look like you're ready for the Opry stage today.
Yeah.
Joining
thank
us
you.
Here
absolutely.
In her lovely dress.
Thank
and
you.
I can just see her up there. So.
Thank you.
Well, to learn more about our friends at the American Heart Association, you can simply go to helpheart.org. Susan Lucci, it's been a pleasure.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for listening to the Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast. Make sure to subscribe so you never miss an episode. And please leave us a 5-star review. This podcast was produced through the facilities of WSM Radio in Nashville, Tennessee. The hosts of Coffee, Country, and Cody are Bill Cody, Charlie Mattos, and Kelly Sutton. Producer, Eric Markham. WSM General Manager and Director of Content and Programming, J. Patrick Tittle. Copyright 2023, Opry Entertainment Group Holdings, LLC.